This course is produced by the Nebraska On-Farm Research Network and Ag Technologies team. In this lecture, we'll cover reasons for conducting on-farm research, basics of experimental design, and tools available to help you conduct on-farm research. We will conclude by introducing you to the data set you will be using for the tutorial exercise. First, a little background about on-farm research in Nebraska. On-farm research efforts in Nebraska Extension began in an organized fashion in 1989 in the east central part of the state. Since then, the program has grown rapidly, both in number of individuals involved, geographic scope, and in the use of technology in conducting research. In 2015, 80 on-farm research studies were completed. Of these, 70% of the studies utilized a yield monitor to record data. Overall, the goal of participants in the Nebraska On-Farm Research Network is to evaluate an alternative production system versus a current system. In this example, a soybean seed treatment, Olivo, is being compared to the farmer's standard seed treatment. In the Nebraska On-Farm Research Network, generally the farmers participating implement the trials and collect the data using their own equipment. Research protocols are designed to fit each farmer's situation and address each farmer's specific interests and questions. The studies are designed in cooperation with Nebraska Extension using sound experimental design and statistical analyses. A focus on long-term agronomic challenges in collaboration with agronomists and others in the ag industry is encouraged. At the end of the growing season, reports are produced and discussed at several on-farm research update meetings held across the state. These meetings typically have excellent dialogue between farmers, consultants, ag industry, and university extension educators and specialists. A financial aspect is included in these reports, and a focus on the economics of the practice being evaluated is encouraged. When asked about motivations for doing on-farm research, farmers generally gave the following reasons. 1. Economic gains. 2. Increased yield. And 3. A desire for reliable test results and data analysis. In a follow-up survey of past on-farm research participants, 80% reported implementing one or more on-farm research proven practice in their operation. Additionally, participants commonly expressed that research done on-farm was more believable to them. So why do on-farm research? Questions addressed are designed to answer your production questions. The research is done in your growing conditions, with your management practices, and with your equipment. On-farm research is a great avenue to reinforce or improve production practices, and on-farm research is a source of reliable, unbiased information. Now let's turn our attention to the basics of experimental design and how to properly set up an on-farm research experiment. Let's take a closer look about how we go about setting up an on-farm research study. Let's say you have a question that you'd like to test on your farm, such as, how will applying fungicide to corn at V5 affect my yield and economics? How would you go about testing this? First, we have identified two treatments, a fungicide application and an untreated check. The placement of these treatments is important. Often, producers like to split fields in half when comparing treatments. If you split this field in half for the two treatments, which treatment, the check, or the fungicide, would you put on which side? Do you put the fungicide on the west and the check on the east, or the other way around? A uniform treatment comparison site is ideal, one where moisture, slope, and soil are the same. This is hard to find, and even what may visually seem uniform may have other unseen factors influencing variability. A field can vary significantly from one edge to the other in its productivity due to soil type, slope, previous history, and other factors. Take a look at the yield map for this field. We can see that the east edge of the field is lower yielding than the west edge of the field. If we used our layout with the fungicide to the west and the check to the east, we would strongly favor the fungicide treatment by placing it in the portion of the field that was more productive. In reality, there are numerous factors, and the yield map may vary from year to year. This makes it even more difficult to determine how you would set up a layout with half of the field in one treatment and half of the field in another treatment. Splitting the field in half doesn't help us answer our research question in a way where we will have confidence in the results. We need a different design. Since simply splitting a field in half doesn't remove the variability, what would happen if we repeated the treatments across the field? Would that solve our problem with variation and give us more confidence in our results? Let's say we begin with the fungicide treatment followed by the check treatment. The combination of the two treatments side by side is called a block and is one replication. Replication is the repeating of the blocks of treatments within the field, commonly 4 to 6 times. Replications can continue to be added as one goes across the field. Replication allows for more data across a field so you can more confidently believe the yield results. However, remember our field variability? Which way did we say the field was more productive? From east to west. So as we look at our treatments, even with replication, we are always favoring the fungicide treatment over the check treatment, just because it is consistently on the better side of the field compared to the check. For this reason, replication alone can't address field variability. To address field variability, both randomization and replication are used. Randomization is used to assign the place of each treatment within a block to eliminate bias of one treatment over another. The assignment is made by chance. This choice can be made by flipping a coin or by using an online tool such as the website random.org. In this case, we still have our two treatments, fungicide versus check, and they are replicated 4 times and randomized. When we factor in field variability, though, we see that we do not always have the same treatment that is favored in this case. In the first block or rep, the fungicide treatment may have the advantage with field variability. However, in the second rep, the check may have the advantage. So with randomization, we're helping to remove an advantage to one treatment over another due to field variability. Blocking, replication, and randomization are important in addressing field variability. This also allows us to use statistics to assess our confidence that yield differences are due to the treatments we are testing and not to other factors like the field variability. The Nebraska On-Farm Research Network has more resources which can help you set up a proper experimental design. This interactive grower's guide covers topics such as site selection, designing your experiment, how to design experiments with 2, 3, or more treatments, tips for collecting data and analyzing results. In this online magazine, you can click to read more, to watch videos, or to access additional resources. The Nebraska On-Farm Research Network has also produced an app available both on Apple App Store and Google Play Store. This tool will help you properly randomize and replicate your treatments. It also allows you to input observations during the growing season and yield data at harvest. You can then send that information to yourself or an extension educator via email. This tool is available for anyone to use at no cost. When planning your on-farm research experiment, it can be helpful to look at what research has already been completed in your area. The Nebraska On-Farm Research Network has numerous resources available online. Visit cropwatch.unl.edu/farmresearch. Online, you can view PDF copies of the annual research report or explore our interactive database of previous research studies. You can filter by county, year, crop, irrigation, and topic, and then click to view the study reports. You can also search by keyword or explore areas near you by clicking on the counties on the map. Now that we've looked at the basics of on-farm research and experimental design, let's take a look at the research study that we will be using in the tutorial. The research question for this study we will be setting up is, what is the impact of soybean planting population on yield? We want to compare four soybean seeding rates. The four rates being tested are 116,000 seeds per acre, 130,000 seeds per acre, 160,000 seeds per acre, and 185,000 seeds per acre. When setting up this trial, it is important to minimize other variables. For example, the same soybean variety should be planted across the entire study area. Here we see the plot layout for the field. You will notice that there are four replications, and each replication contains all four treatments. In this case, the treatments are seeding rates. You may also notice that the order that the seeding rates occur are different in each of the replications. This is due to randomization of the treatments. In this tutorial, we'll be creating a prescription that can be loaded into the tractor to be used to implement this on-farm research experiment. If you choose to proceed to the next tutorial, we will be analyzing the yield data from this on-farm research experiment and conducting a statistical analysis. Let's go over the data layers we'll be working with in this exercise. This is the field we'll be working on. It is located in southeast Nebraska. The grain yield from 2015 is provided. We will use this data as a reference data set to line up our experiment. This is the product we'll be creating in this tutorial. It is a seeding rate prescription to test the four seeding rates we are interested in using a randomized and replicated treatment layout. We will then show how to export this prescription to a field monitor setup. All right, let's get started.